Located in Anantapura district of Andhra Pradesh, Lepakshi makes a great destination for a day trip from Bangalore. Lepakshi is at a distance of 120 km from Bangalore and it takes only 2 hours to reach the place by car via Bangalore-Hyderabad highway. Before reaching the main temple at Lepakshi, you will be welcomed by a large monolithic Nandi. The giant statue of Jatayu, built recently near the Nandi statue, also attracts a lot of tourists. This Nandi statue in Lepakshi is made of a single granite stone and is said to be one of the largest monolithic statues in India. It is 20 feet in height and 30 feet in length. It was built in 1583 by the rulers of the Vijayanagara Empire. According to the Valmiki Ramayana, it is believed that this was the place where Rama had met the dying Jatayu and had helped him achieve salvation by uttering the words Le Pakshi or Rise, O Bird in Telugu. Veerabhadra Swami Temple of Lepakshi is just 500 meters from the location of the Nandi statue. The temple dates back to 1583 and was built by the brothers Virupanna and Veeranna, who were initially in the service of the Vijayanagara kings. However, another legend states that the temple was built by the sage Agastya. As soon as you enter the temple, Natyamantapa and Ardhamantapa greet you with eye-catchy and artistically beautiful sculptures. The temple was built on a small hillock, which is in the shape of tortoise and hence known as Kurma Shaila. Temple's main deity is Veerabhadra, the fiery god created by Shiva. The sanctum also houses the shrines of Lord Shiva, Lord Vishnu, Ramalinga, Bhadrakali and Hanuman. The Lepakshi temple also has the finest specimens of mural paintings of the Vijayanagara kings. The ceilings of the Natya and Ardha Mantapa are decorated with murals that depict scenes from the epics like Mahabharata, Ramayana and the Puranas. The Shiva Parvati wedding painting is the most notable among the rest. Due to the lack of maintenance and preservation, these rare beautiful wall paintings are slowly fading off. There are about 35 large pillars in the mantapa, and the most important one is the hanging pillar, which is suspended a few inches above the floor and does not rest on the ground fully. It is said that the pillar is dispositioned a bit after the British engineer tried to move it in an unsuccessful attempt to uncover the secret of its support. Massive 18 feet monolithic Nagalinga attracts the visitors with 3 coils and 7 hoods. It is located right behind the main temple. It provides shelter to black granite Shivalingam. A huge Ganesha present at the right side is carved out of the same boulder as Nagalinga. These maroon spots are said to be the marks left by the bleeding eyes of Virupanna. You can read the full story in the description. Yet another prime attraction within the Virabhadra Swami temple complex of Lepakshi is Kalyana Mantapa. Similar to the structure of the main temple Mantapa, the Kalyana Mantapa has a circular arrangement of pillars. It was built to perform the wedding ceremony of Lord Shiva and Parvati during the annual festivals of the temple. There are about 38 pillars in the mantapa carved out of granite stone that exhibits the carvings of several gods and saints. According to legend, the main architect Virupanna ran out of funds while trying to build and complete the Kalyana Mantapa. Hence the structure stands unfinished. There is a large open area beyond the Kalyana Mantapa which was used for cultural and recreational activities during the Vijayanagara rule. In the courtyard, you can also find giant pallets carved out of stone. Even though there is no relevant information regarding these, one can only guess that these might have been used as the place to serve the offerings to God during the puja ceremony. A series of pillars at the backside of Kalyana Mantapa has beautiful intricate designs carved on them. These carvings have also inspired the designs of famous Lepakshi sarees. One corner of the courtyard, there lies this big footprint impression. Some believe that it is of Lord Hanuman's and others say it is of Sita's. It is interesting to note that this imprint remains wet during all the season.
Thanks for watching this video. If you like the content made by us, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.